Yahoo and welcome back to another episode of me talking about everyone's beloved bastard teacher, Ruki Dinashi of whatever, whatever Akashic Records. Oh boy, this episode. Rumia won't be able to get any rest without being kidnapped, trying to be killed or executed in the name of the Queen. Oh boy. Give her some rest, please. I mean, wouldn't a normal light novel go for the different character arcs when we're coming to help a girl or save them, going girl by girl by girl, and not like, oh yeah, this is basically the main female love interested, but then the other girl, her non-blood related sister, for whatever reason, is kidnapped. She will be saved, and then, bam, 2 episodes later, oh yeah, we are trying to kill her. Why? Well, because we can. Yeah, this is strange. I still enjoyed a very entertaining show, but man, the reason why they are doing this shit to her, not so sure. It feels like a pain in the ass. It's just pointless, useless, annoying. I hate it. Not, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that the show is bad. It's just that what those dudes are trying to do with Rumia, this is bad. This is real shit. But then I will be glad that we have Glenn, that bastard of a teacher, and yeah, basically everything will be fine, because it's just this type of show. So yeah, Rumia got into trouble. She was surrounded, taken away by the Imperial Guards, because the Queen was at the competition of the school, and the Queen went to see her, but Rumia ran basically away, said that she had the wrong girl, which makes sense. And the Queen asked Glenn to take care of him because she knows Glenn for quite a while. Which brings us back to Glenn's past as a soldier. Or the, basically, magician of justice. Lol. But yeah, he going around. There were quite a bit of comedy as well, with the new two characters, Albert and Real, or what her name was. Obviously, she is really, really cute, okay? I really like her design and her deadpan face. But man, that guy, yeah, quite the serious dude when it comes to jobs. And yeah, they are not the bad dudes, it's so obvious. I mean, otherwise they would do some stuff, but they're actually there and trying to look into what the Imperial Guards are up to. Even though the girl attacked Glenn at the end of the episode, but yeah, she said before that she has to settle a score with him, because they know each other. And yeah, I think she will fall for him as well, because from the opening sequence, it's pretty clear that she's one of the main heroines. Not that I would complain about it, but just give Celica some more love, please. It's just my rotten luck. So many nice side characters across different shows and stories, and they're just side characters. Man, this sucks. I want to cry. Seriously. Yeah, but okay, all joking aside, it's obvious that she will fall for Glenn, because Glenn is a bastard of a teacher, and she is a bit weird. In a cute way. But damn, I'm still curious to see why the Imperial Guards are trying to execute Rumia. It should be obvious about the special powers or whatever it is, and yeah, but I don't really get why they are using the name of the queen for it. Maybe to just get away with it for no reason. But man, what I would love to see would be their expression, their reaction. If Glenn would kinda show up with a corpse like Rumia in front of the queen and saying that she was executed by the Imperial Guards. Man, this would be fun. But obviously they would deny it and just go with the bullshit. So yeah, kinda like this. But man, the queen's reaction to this would be pretty good. I know I'm an asshole for saying this, but I would love to see this. Just because she, I don't know, lost control about her own Imperial Guards? I mean, come on, this is so old. The king or the queen losing the control over the guards? Man, this is shit on this gets old. I don't really like this stuff. But yeah, overall, Glenn has to do some work, getting close to the queen and solving the problem and beating probably some assholes up, which we will probably do. And yeah, I think the two new characters that showed up in the end will come handy and will not save him, but will be helpful in a couple of ways. And yeah, I'm also curious to see where this is going with the new girl showing up that was attacking Glenn. Because I really like her character design. She looks so cute, like a cute little kitten. Can I take her home? With Rumia and Sisti? And Slick? God damn it, I should get some sleep. I'm talking nonsense. So yeah, interesting episode with more development. Especially for Rumia, even though she's kinda quick to give up on life. Even though she doesn't want to, but man, yeah, whatever. I'm still curious how the queen would react if Rumia would really die. Just in front of her. Oh god, yeah. I should stop with that train of thought. It's not going in a good direction after watching World End. Man, this hit me hard. So yeah, next week, probably the second volume of the light novel will be adapted or finished. The current arc, saving Rumia, solving the problem with the queen and beating the shit out of one of the Imperial Guards, probably that Zelos dude. I mean, it's obvious he looks like the bad, shitty, evil dude, and yeah, the maid will be, she's also obviously one of the evil dudes, but yeah, can't really confirm that right now, but yeah, it's just what I think it will be. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow is Wednesday, and there will we have, what will we have? I think Puso Shoujo and Sakurada Reset. And another busy day. Anyways, good night. Thanks for watching. See you later. Bye bye.